Welcome all to Maya Hacks. I'm Vishal Rain. In this video tutorial, we will see procedural eye shading using V-Ray in Maya 2018. Right now, I've got a simple polygon scene here, polygon models. One is the poly disk here, which you can generally create by just shift right click. You got the disk here, and then you can scale it to the size you want. And I've got a model here which is in basically two pieces here. I would like to create the whole thing from scratch, so let's create a simple polygon sphere. I'll not move it anywhere else. I rotate this poly sphere 90 degrees. I want to add a subdivisions of 40 in axis and 40 in height. For time being, I switch off the visibility of the disk. I select this polygon sphere and duplicate it. I select the first sphere which has a construction history. I'll add a radius of 1.001, which is slightly larger to the size of what we had earlier. So very slight margin I've kept here. So if you just see here, I've got two polygon spheres. One sphere is a bigger one and another one is a smaller one. The bigger one, I would like to select it and name it as outer eye geometry. And the other one, I'll name it as inner eye geometry. I would select these two geometries and group it. Before grouping it, I select the outer eye geometry and just switch off the visibility so that I can work comfortably on the inner one. I select the vertex point of the pole here. Using soft selection, I would like to select a range of vertices and I simply move it inside. I just want to get that concave shape here. I'm modeling the iris part and the pupil part here. So I'm going to select the vertex here in the middle, convert that selection into the faces and get rid of that face. So here I'm getting that concave shape here. The hole represents the pupil of the eye. I'm going to add a line here using insert edge loop tool. I'm going to select the border edge and I just move it inside. And I'll add one more line here. And I just want this to be quite soft. So I'm using slide edge tool to just slide it over. And I want this quite a concave shaped thing. So I'm going to move it to my desired shape here. Using insert edge loop tool, I'll add a line here to preserve that concaveness. I select edit delete by type history, so to delete the whole geometry here, the history here. I bring the outer geometry here. I switch on the visibility of the geometry and I'm going to select the vertex point here. Using soft selection, I'm going to move it outside. So I'm here trying to create that convex shape what we generally see in the eyeball. So I've got a slightly concave shape here. I'll just slightly modify the shape here edge by edge to get that nice bulge in the front side of the model. So I'm going to select these two pieces, the two geometries. I'm going to group it and I'm going to call this as eye geometry. I'll bring the disk geometry here. I select the eye geometry. I select the eye geometry and just move it above the eye here. I can scale it slightly bigger. I scale it so that I can get the size of the textures. I may use 3D textures, so keeping that in mind, I'm scaling it to 2 units. So I'll switch this to perspective 1 camera. I'm going to use V-Ray here for my rendering. So I just choose my render settings, and here I'm going to use V-Ray. And here I'm going to choose the size to 600 pixels. I want a smaller render so that I can do the quick play blast here. Generally, this use V-Ray framework for auction is off by default. I'm going to make it on, and I'm going to convert image to sRGB for render view option on. Generally, it may be off generally, so I'll keep it off. I'll just explain you what I'm trying to do here. So I'm going to select this all geometry and assign an existing V-Ray material which is there here. I will select the outer geometry and I'm going to hide it for a while. I'm going to just select this camera. Just want to see whether I'm in the right side or not. So I'm rotating this view. So I just want it quite closer and a 3/4 view of the whole scene. So I'm going to select that camera and lock the camera by some reason. Generally, if we accidentally move it, then the renders comparison may not go correctly. So for that purpose, I want to lock the camera, and I just want to see the previous and current render every time. At this point of time, I want to do the lighting. So I'm going to select a V-Ray sphere light. I just wanted to put it here on the front, right above, on the left side, or left or right side maybe. So I'm going to just move it up. I'm going to select the attribute editor, and here we got an option called radius. I'm going to scale it down to 0.3 or 0.4 here. I'm going to just render this scene. I just want to see how the whole thing is turning up. So I go to the render settings, and we have an option called show V-Ray frame buffer option. Just clicking that gives me the V-Ray frame buffer. Here we have IPR render and a normal render. So I'm going to render it with normal render. I just want to see how this is turning up. Just let me just get into the icons here and search for this option. If you could see here, display colors in sRGB space, I'll enable it. Okay, so it is already enabled, and I'm seeing a quite bright image here. I would also get into the GI and make this GI on and leave everything to the default. I just want that global illumination also happening. So I just want that concave thing, so this part is brighter and that part is darker comparing to. I can generally select and do the soft selection and then move it deep so that I can get more concave effect. So I just send this image using this particular option. Send this image to Maya's render view. That will generally send that image to the render view here. Okay, the render should be same, and the conversion should be same. So I'm use generally, if you get into this particular option here, convert images to sRGB for render view should do it. So let me see what's wrong with that. So generally doing that should give the difference. If I don't do that, the image may look linear. If I on this and then send it to the render view, it should generally send as an sRGB view, not the linear image. Okay, so I've got this image, so I'm going to create one more render. I just want to go for one more render. I'll just save that render and then see. So if you see here, there's not much difference. I need to just check with that. I didn't send that to the render view. You could see the difference here. There is some depth created in this. So I want more dark and more light. A very clear contrast between that two regions. Okay, so I've got this. I just want to do a quick light setup here again so that I could get some lighting on the back side as well. So I'm going to create another light. So I'm using V-Ray sphere light again, and I'm going to put it on the back side of the scene here. So this should generally give me a sort of rim light for the model. Okay, let's keep this for the comparison and then see it again. So you see that the opposite side is also filled. So that's the key light and that's the rim light. I can create a dome light. This should fill the whole scene uniformly, just simulating the skylight. So I'm going to render it again. So it's a completely bright scene comparing to what we had earlier. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the IPR render here, and I'm going to reduce the intensity to 0.1. I just want to see the key light, the rim light and the fill light which I have achieved from this. So I'm going to put this to 0.05 or 0.1, 0.08. 0.8 looks decent enough. So I'm going to use this invisible option so that I may not see the background of the light. I mean, the light is not rendered as the visibility, so it's not seen. Generally it generally creates lighting, but it's not seen if the option is on here. So I've got my basic light setup done here. So I've got this model. I'm going to select this and assign a new V-Ray material. So I'm using V-Ray material. I just select the camera and just go for slightly front view. So I just unlock it and slightly rotate it. Okay, let me select the eyeball and then see what shader I have assigned. So for this new shader, I'm going to name this as Iris shader. So in this Iris shader, I just want to create a ramp in the diffuse color. So I'm creating the ramp, rendering the perspective camera, and trying to locate that iris with this. Initially, I just take simple yellow and red color so that it's seen clearly where this whole thing is. connected. So if you could see, this is red color, the iris, and the yellow color is the other part of the eye. So I'm going to select this yellow color, make it black, and leave that red color, and this is where I want my iris to be. So I'm going to select this red color, and in that red color region I'm going to add two more color inputs, or maybe three. So this, the first one here, I'll make it black to give that slight fading effect here. And this particular color, which is the inner one, I leave it to the red. And the next color, I make it slightly darker. And this one, make it black. So I just want that gradation happening here. I can just check different blending modes these ramps are. So I use the smooth here in this case, and leave it like that. Okay, so I just I don't worry about the colors right now. I just get into the hyper shade, bring the iris shader, and if you could see, we got a ramp. I select that, go to edit, duplicate shading network, gives me a new ramp, and I select that ramp and assign that to the bump of the V-Ray shader. So I'll just go down, and there I'm going to connect it to the bump. I select that ramp, this is ramp 2. I can name this as ramp bump. So I'm going to select all the colors to gray, that is the 50% gray. So I choose the value of 0.5. done. The next color, value, saturation 0, done. Okay. In the red color area, this area, I'm going to choose a simple fractal or noise texture. So it can be a fractal or it can be a noise texture, a noise or fractal. So I'm going to use fractal texture here. So you should get that slight bump details here, what you're seeing. I'm reducing the amplitude, and I use a select region option so that I can speed up the whole rendering process. I would like to repeat U direction 2 times so that I get more clear lines there. So I've got this fractal texture. I'm going to delete that next input so that that will be stretched throughout that. You can just explore the fractal. You can add inflections or change the bias and see what generally suits you. Generally, I'm leaving at this point of time. I'm not doing much with that. So I'll just get into the diffuse options. In diffuse option, we got the red color. There I'm going to use a fractal again. So if you're using fractal in bump, use fractal in color as well. So that should colorize the whole thing. I'm reducing the amplitude, and I'm repeating that equal to what I've done into the bump area. It's, if you see, this is white and black color, gives that nice details. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change that white and black color into any color which I want. So there is an option called remap. If I click this insert button, it may create a ramp here. That ramp will generally have two color inputs. So I'm going to choose yellow in one input and some green in the other input. Then you should see that the black colors are replaced by the green, yellow is replaced by the white. So choose the brighter color of iris. If you are doing a brown eye, then precisely choose a light color brown on this side, and on the other side here choose a darker one of it. So generally you see that variation. So whatever the procedure I have done here, I'll be doing for the second range of colors. So in that color I'm going to use fractal again, and I'm going to repeat this too, and I'm going to reduce the amplitude so that it becomes more softer, and I'm going to insert again a new ramp, and here I'm going to choose the slightly darker color, and here the slightly darker color. So the inner one should be more brighter. So here the ramp what I've taken should be slightly brighter than comparing to what I've done on the edges. So I can generally add more saturation if I need it, like that. So I've just got this ramp two here, which is ramp one, which is the color here. So I'm going to connect reflection also with the ramp so that I get that response of iris to the light. So I just get into the hyper shade, so this ramp which I've created in the color, I'll be adding that in the reflection as well. So I just switch off the Fresnel so that the reflections are can be seen. So I just if you could see, the ramp is not making much difference, so I'll choose the hyper shade. If you could see, there are two possible connections. I break the reflections and I choose color correct node. So in color correct node, I'll connect the ramp one as the input, and then I take that output of the color correction to the reflection. So in the color correction option, I can generally increase the value or change the saturation or change the hue of the whole thing. So generally it can be a secondary control for me for my existing ramp. So I'll be using this value. I'll increase 1.5 and I should see much more brighter reflections if needed. So this will give you an extra control later. So the glossiness, I'll set it to 0.5, and this will generally change its bright and darkness based on the light. So I reduce the amount of reflections also. It should be very low and subtle, and it should be quite responding to the light. So that I've got some basic iris. I'll bring the outer layer aside, bring its visibility, so I'll render a bigger region this time and render it. I'll just save this file for now, then again re-render it. So just show wave. So for this particular outer geometry, I'm going to assign a new V-Ray material, but this time I just want to play with a V-Ray blend material where I want to add more materials into it. So initially I would like to start with V-Ray blend material. V-Ray blend material works very similar to the layers in Photoshop. If you see, there is a base material, it will be a base material, like if you're doing a car paint shade, car material. So you do the car paint first, then you want to add some decals on it, So you can put the decals in the next layer with different material properties. Then maybe you want to add some dust layers and all, and you can just keep on adding that. So it is layers by material. So I'm not going to use base material here, I'm going to use coat materials only. So in the first coat material, I would like to choose a material which can actually simulate the cornea of the eye, which can show that refractive index values of the cornea. So I just in the coat material 0, I just click and take a V-Ray material. In that, I'm going to name this as cornea shader. And here I'm going to I start rendering this. So if you see, this is quite opaque here right now. It's quite dark because the blend amount is gray. I put it to white, so it get back its color. And now I just get into the V-Ray material and change the diffuse color to black, and just go down to the refraction value and make the refraction color white so that the whole thing becomes transparent. And again, I change the refractive index value to 1.376, which is the refractive index value of the cornea of the human eye. So I'm keeping that. Effect shadows, I switch it on and I just leave it like that. Just want to show you what this actually doing. For that, I'm going to select the camera, unlock it for a while. And I'm going to rotate this slightly and just see what happens in the bulge of this. So let me render this. I switch off the render region and then render this view. So I need to get that bulge and that distortion of the iris should be seen clearly. So this is what I want. So I got my first shader, which should generally do that iris part, or refraction of the iris part, and it's doing precisely correct. So I just want to, I'm happy at this point of time. So I'll just get into the blend material. Let me lock it. I select the outer geometry, and in the coat material 2, I'm going to add the V-Ray skin shader. So I'm using V-Ray fast triple S shader, and it should generally showcase that subsurface scattering effect. So I'm going to use the IPR render with render region option. So it should give us that scattering behavior. We have the presets here. You can choose any preset like marble, milk skimmed, milk whole, skin. So I just choose milk. Let's see what I get. So it generally changes the whole overall behavior. So I just keep it slightly reddish, because I'm going to do that eyeball, which should behave like organic eyeball, which is filled with blood inside it. So I reduce the scatter radius to 0.25. And here, if you notice subsurface color there, I'm going to use a ramp. So let's take the ramp here. And I'm not very precise, I'm roughly moving this whole thing here, and here leaving the first input. In the second input, I just put one more input here, so there are total 3 inputs. So in the middle input, I'm going to take a 3D texture. That 3D texture should be marble here. So So I can click 3D textures and choose marble texture. So you should get that vein type of sort of details. The vein width, as you could see, the veins are blending. That is because we have taken a color input here, and that gradual fall off is seen here. So I select that and then change the thickness to 0.01. So it should be very thin. And also you can add more noise if you want in this. So it is 1.5, let me put it to 1.8. And I can generally change that color of the veins to slight reddish and just leave it. If you could see this veins, okay, I can reduce the contrast and diffuse values and keep that lines very thin and separated. Now we got two colors, one is the vein and another one is the white, the filler color. So in the filler color, I'll add another marble texture. Another marble, that marble is also has got same placement. In that case, select the placement of the second marble. I'm adding a second layer here, so that's added in the filler color. That second marble, I do a slight modification, whatever you want, just do it. That will add a second layer of this. So here we select the same previous vein color and then we reduce the vein width, or maybe you can put it slight reduce, less a diffuse value. You can add slightly less contrast, and I can generally take another marble and with some other placement. So rotation, translation, whatever you want to do, how much you want to do, you give it, gives that new placement here. So once you got that, choose that color. So I'm getting that layers and layers on top of this. I reduce the vein width and I keep it slightly diffused in this case, and take that color, and it should be slightly lesser, but not white actually. I can generally add a slightly yellowish tint to it. So you should see that nice yellowish and vein patterns here. You see that nice. So how many marble layers you can add, it gives that many layers of veins, and I'm quite happy at this point of time. I just go back to the ramp, and here I can generally move it so that this ramp will be nicely pulled forward so that it can be seen through the slit of the eye. This part is not visible to the camera, mainly this part is visible. Even I can choose the exponential up, that gives a soft blending towards upside of the ramp, and I could see more veins clearly coming till the iris part of the model. So I just move this, I could see that whole thing is here. So this color, what you're seeing, white color, I'm going to pick that yellow or slightly greenish, or maybe okay. So I got that a blood filled eyeball, slightly fading, blending here. I should move this slightly till there. Okay, so far I got some decent result at this point of time. Let me get into the hyper shade, bring that V-Ray shader. So you should see marble getting into the ramp, and that's you got here. So I select this ramp and directly connect into the pump. I'm not I could generally sense the reds and this yellows. So yellows are lighter and reds are more darker if I generally desaturate it. So I'm going to select the V-Ray material, and in the bump I'm going to connect that ramp directly, not playing much about So when I do that, I get the bump here. But this bump is generally giving that cavities inside the in the vein part. So in that case, I can choose a negative value so that the veins are now pumped out. So you see that slight bump. So in fact, I can generally not use the bump in this layer because I want some other material to be used in this case, or maybe I can stick with it also. Let me try it first. So I'm going to stop it. I just want to change the camera view. Every time changing camera views, if it's not working for you, you can create a second camera and render things from that second camera. So I'm going to render it again. If you see, there is a specular layer and the glossiness component. I really don't see much of this part in the camera, so I really don't worry about how these things are turning up. I just increased the specular component and increased the glossiness of this. If you feel that this part should be slightly rough than the iris part, then you can generally create a texture which can control that difference. So let me create a ramp here. If you see, I just created that glossiness here. The size of this dot is based on the light which we have created. The light first time which we have created as a radius of 0.4, I'll increase that to 1. Then you should see that radius becomes bigger. So I just select the model here, the outer part. And if you see here, the blend amount is too less, and it's becoming completely opaque. This is the main concern about at this point of time. So to avoid this, I'm going to make it transparent. So I'm going to use the ramp here, and so this part is this triple S shader, and this part is transparent. So just spend some time and try to make this triple S shader opaque till this point, and then transparent so that you can see the inner model iris here. So what I'm going to do is just get back to the blend material, and here choose the coat material. So in coat material, again, coat material 2, I'm going to use V-Ray material, which comes on the top, make it completely opaque. And then in coat material 2, change the diffuse color black and make it reflective. Okay. So in this case, what we do is make it additive. So that should add that texture on top of it. I mean the shader on top of it. So I've got this. So in this particular coat material 19, okay, use Fresnel. Let's go down. So into the bump map, I would like to add that ramp. So that should add that roughness to it. So there is a very clear separation, and we got very rough details. So instead of doing that way, we may create duplicate this shading network, so that newly created ramp goes into V-Ray material 19, that is ramp number 5 here. Okay, I select that ramp and now start changing the colors. So I select this black color and pick saturation 0, value 0.5, which should give the gray color. The next color is also the same color, so that should not give me that hard separation. Now in this area where the whole thing is, so this one also I take the gray, and here I would like to add the gray but slightly brighter, 0.55. so I'll just keep two colors with me. So that should add that should give me slightly slight bump on the whole model. Okay, so I can select the auto model, and then in the triple shader where I was using this ramps, there I just want to make these colors quite more red. Just trying to go for different values. To give that different layers of blood, some are deep and some are peripheral, and that should be clearly seen in this. So I just made it more clear. So I just come back here, and in this particular color I want to pick more lighter color. You should see that. So I just render this. To add more interest to the whole scene, the scene should be quite dramatic. I mean, the background reflections are making the whole thing interesting. So adding more lights in the scene can generally do much more or add more interest to the whole scene, more reflections and all. So you could see that reflections are added on top. So I can check by different views also. So you should see that iris refraction perfectly, and you got that bump details of the veins coming out nicely. I haven't changed any render settings here to get a better result. Generally, when you're going for a final result, you can increase the render settings so that you get much better result. As it's all our test renders, I'm ending up with this. So I'll just stop this render, and generally if you notice here, the whole thing was achieved by simple layering of procedural textures. So we were trying to simulate the real eyeball, eyeball which humans have or any other animal have, the depth of the iris, the hole which you see in the iris, which we call as pupil. So we have simulated and building such model, and if you can understand the eyeball construction, how anatomically it is, and you can generally create a very precise eyeball shading. Colors are basically maybe here and there, but you can generally take color picking references for your work. You may have different eye colors, gray, blue, brown, black. So based on the rays, you can generally change the colors and all and achieve your desired look. It's all about trial and error until you get it, get more revisions and get the best you want from it. I'm going to even upload this file for you so that you can check it out. This is this scene is done in Maya 2018 using V-Ray for 2018. So if you have any queries, please post comments in the ask me in the comment section. Hope I'll come with some more interesting tutorials in the next session. Thank you very much.